Hello friends, today in continuation with our learning, we'll learn about continuity of a function. Okay, as you can see in question number 1, question says fx equal to x over x square plus 3x, and we have to check whether the function is continuous at these values or no, at x equal to minus 3 and at x equal to 0. Is it continuous or no? Okay, so in the given function, the graph is given to us. We can see that at minus 3, you can see where is x minus 3? It is here, right? I am marking it with blue. X is minus 3 at this point. And at this point, all throughout, we have an vertical asymptote at minus 3. Okay, so because we have a vertical asymptote at minus 3, at x equal to minus 3, you can see the dotted line, that is called an asymptote. So that is why we will say that at minus 3 we have a infinite discontinuity. Let me write it. Infinite discontinuity. The function is not continuous at minus 3. So we have infinite discontinuity. Okay. Then at x equal to 0, you can see where is x value 0? It is at origin. Okay, and you can see there is a hollow circle in the graph. So at that point where x is 0, there is a hollow circle. So that is called a removable discontinuity. Removable discontinuity. Why do we give this name? Because this discontinuity can be removed by putting certain conditions. What conditions can we put to remove this discontinuity? That we'll learn later. But please remember, like wherever you get a hole in the graph, that is called a removable discontinuity. Okay, fine. Let's come to next question, question number 2. In question number 2, the functions presentations are different. Fx is minus 2 when x value is less than equal to 3. And it is given x minus 5 when x is greater than 3. We have to check whether function is continuous at 3 or no. So where is x equal to 3? I can see it is here. Now, please understand, a function is said to be continuous if we can draw the graph entirely without taking the pen out, like without means without removing the pen. If we can draw the function, it is said to be continuous. So at 3, we can see there is a graph drawn, and at 3, we don't need to remove the pen. Without removing the pen, we can draw the graph. So we can say that function is continuous at x equal to 3. There is no discontinuity at 3. Right? Let's come to next question. Question number 3. As you can see here, in question number 3, only the function is given, not the graph is. Okay. So yes, we'll understand. Because it is a rational function, so first we will check whether do we have any asymptote or no. Okay. Now please understand, I am first looking at the continuity. Okay. So do we get any value of x for which the denominator becomes 0? We'll check it out. Okay. So at minus 3, we'll just check out whether does this give 0 or no. So minus 3 whole square, I'm putting in the denominator. Plus, because I'm interested in knowing whether the function is continuous at that point or no. 2 times minus 3 plus 2. So minus 3 whole square is 9 minus 6 plus 2. We get 5. So at minus 3, denominator is not 0. Okay. So the function is not going to be discontinuous at all. The only point of discontinuity was whether the denominator is 0 or no. Okay. So it is not discontinuous. So we'll just say that the function is continuous at x equal to minus 3. Right? Okay. Now we look at question number 4. At question number 4, my friends, question number 4 is very similar to question number 3 with a small difference. Okay? We'll understand the difference, why and how. Okay. It is also in the form of, it's a rational function, right? We have to check the continuity at two points, at minus 2 and at 2. So like the way we did in the previous question, we will do the same way. So I'm just checking whether my denominator is 0 or no by putting x minus 2 and x equal to 2. So yes, we get minus 2 whole square minus 4. I'm putting on denominator, so I get 0. And similarly, when I put 2 also, we get 0, right? So yes, for both these points, function is not continuous. It is discontinuous. But now we have to check what kind of discontinuity is there, okay? So the nature of discontinuity to decide, we need to solve the rational function nicely. Let's see. Numerator is x plus 2 and denominator is x square minus 4. From algebra, you can understand that it can be written as x square minus 2 square, and which is x plus 2 over, that can be written as x plus 2 times x minus 2. Okay. Now, with simplification, you know that x plus 2 and x plus 2 part can be cancelled when that part is not 0. Okay. So we'll write that. Please understand. So I will cancel them and will say this is done when x plus 2 part is not equal to 0. It means x is not equal to minus 2. Okay. So basically, at minus 2, at this common factor, we get the removable discontinuity. Okay. So at minus 2, because x plus 2 is the common factor, right? So x plus 2 is the common factor, which gives x equal to minus 2. So this will give you removable discontinuity. The common factor also always gives removable discontinuity. Okay. And while simplifying, we get this as a rational function. Okay. And you know very well, denominator 0 makes the infinite discontinuity. Why? Because it makes the vertical asymptote. So this will make the infinite discontinuity. So we will have infinite discontinuity at x minus 2 equal to 0, or we can say at x equal to 2, right? So at x equal to 2, we will get infinite discontinuity, infinite. Hope it makes sense. Let's try next question, question number 5. At question number 5, it is again a rational function and there is no common factor possible. So there is no removable discontinuity possible. We will check whether at minus 1, this gives 0 or no. So yes, when I put in minus 1 plus 1, I get 0. It means when x is minus 1, the denominator will become 0, and that is why it is an infinite discontinuity. Whenever denominator makes 0, it is at infinite discontinuity. Infinite discontinuity at x equal to minus 1. Right? Let's try next question, question number 6. Okay. Question number 6 is exactly the way we had done question number 2, right? We'll check the discontinuity or no now. So what we do is, at x equal to 3, we have to check the discontinuity. So we'll plug in 3 in both the parts, here in this section as well as in the second section. So what do we get when I put 3? Minus 2 times 3, we will get 6. And then when I put on the second part, so it is minus 3 square plus 8 times 3, minus 16. So we get minus 9 plus 24 minus 6. So minus 16. So we get minus 25 plus 24, and that gives minus 1. So this value and this value is not same, hence it is a discontinuous. And what kind of discontinuity is this? It is a third kind of discontinuity, which is called jump discontinuity. We'll understand by graph why it is jump discontinuity. Because at the same point at x equal to 3, the first part of the function gives y value as 6, whereas the second part of the function gives y value as minus 1. That is why the function is not continuous at 3, and that discontinuity is called jump discontinuity. So this is jump discontinuity. Okay, let's come to question number 7th now. We have to determine if each function is continuous or no. If not continuous, find the x-axis location of and classify each discontinuity. Okay. Because it is a rational function, so we will have two jobs. First, to check whether do we have a common factor in numerator and denominator, and second is there any value of x for which denominator is 0 or no. So there is no common factor between numerator and denominator. So if there is no common factor, then there is no removable discontinuity. Good, because removable discontinuity is for common factors. Okay, and then we'll check, does the denominator make 0 for any value of x? We'll check that. So I'm just using a quadratic knowledge, plus 1 equal to 0. I'm just checking whether for any value of x this makes 0 or no. So you know how to solve quadratic function. We'll use quadratic formula. Minus b plus minus square root b square minus 4 times a times c, whole divided by 2 times a, which is 2 times 2. So we'll just solve it. Minus 2 plus minus square root 4 minus 8 divided by 4. Now guys, please understand, in the square root you see it is 4 minus 8, which is a negative result. It means it will not give any real value, right? So there is no real value of x which can make this denominator 0. It means that there is no value of x which will make the denominator 0. It means the function is continuous throughout. We have no discontinuity at all, either removable discontinuity or infinite discontinuity. Again, repeating, Removable discontinuity is when numerator and denominator sum factors are same, and infinite discontinuity is when denominator makes zero. So there is no value of x which makes zero, hence there is no infinite discontinuity. Fine. So it means this function is continuous throughout. I'm just writing it. Continuous throughout. Okay. Let's come to number 8. Again, we will apply the same concept. We'll first check whether do we have any common factors between numerator and denominator or no. So there is no common factor, so there is no removable discontinuity at all. Let's check the denominator is 0 or no. So let's make the denominator equal to 0 and we'll try to find the value of x. So yes, you can do it and we will get x equal to minus 3. So there are two values of x which can make 0, minus 3 and minus 3. Anyway, so because denominator is making 0 for minus 3, so this is infinite discontinuity. Make sense? Infinite. Let's come to next question. Question number 9. Question number 9, we'll try to factorize the numerator. We get x plus 3, x plus 1 over x plus 3. And yes, there are common factors. X plus 3 is the common factor. So we can see that it is a removable discontinuity. Let me write that. Removable discontinuity at x plus 3 equal to 0, or you can say x equal to minus 3. Okay. And yes, because when there is a removable discontinuity, so we will simplify them and we'll get x plus 1 as a function. Now this function does not have any kind of discontinuity. So there is only one discontinuity, which is removable discontinuity. Please understand, guys, in this case you will not make denominator equal to 0 just to make infinite discontinuity. Okay. After we get removable discontinuity, we'll simplify the function, and my simplified function is x plus 1, which is continuous throughout. So this entire function has just one discontinuity, which is removable discontinuity at x equal to minus 3. Okay. Let's come to next question, 10th. We'll try to simplify numerator and denominator. Numerator, keep it as it is. In denominator, we can take common factor x. So we get x minus 4. Now, x and x are common factors, so we can cancel them. Let me cancel, simplify. So we get 1 over x minus 4. So first of all, there is a removable discontinuity because the common factor is x. So I'm writing removable discontinuity at that common factor, I will write at x equal to 0, right? The common factor equal to 0 makes the removable discontinuity. And then after simplified function, the denominator is x minus 4, right? So there is an infinite discontinuity when the denominator will be 0. So infinite discontinuity at x minus 4 equal to 0, that is x equal to 4, right? Okay, let's try question number 11. The function is written differently in 11. It's a piecewise function, so we'll solve it in a different way. We have to check where the function is discontinuous. Now, because the first part of a function is a linear function, so it is continuous throughout. Second part is also a linear function, so it is continuous throughout. The only point to check is whether they are continuous at this point or no, at minus 2 or no. Okay? Because before minus 2, the first function is always continuous. After minus 2, the second function is always continuous. So my point is only to check at minus 2. So I will check at minus 2. So when I put minus 2 on the first function, what do I get? Minus 2 plus 4, we get 2. And when I put on the second function, what do I get? Minus 2 times minus 2, minus 11, equal to 4 minus 11, which gives minus 7. Now this value and this value is not same because 2 is not equal to minus 7. So it is a discontinuous function, and you remember third kind of discontinuity was jump discontinuity. Okay, so this is a jump discontinuity at x equal to minus 2. Let's try next question, number 12. It's again a rational function. We'll try to solve if we can do any simplification. X plus 7 over denominator, we can take x common, so it is x plus 3. Now there is no common factor, so for sure there is no removable discontinuity. And yes, we'll try to make the denominator 0 just to check infinite discontinuity. So that will give x equal to 0 or x plus 3 equal to 0. I hope you understand basic algebra. So x equal to minus 3. So basically there are two values of x where there is an infinite discontinuity, 0 and minus 3. Infinite discontinuity at x equal to 0 and minus 3. Right? Okay. Let's come to next question. Question number 13. We have to find the intervals on which each function is continuous. It's a piecewise function, and the function is a linear function in the first part, and in the second part also is a linear function. So it is continuous before 4 and after 4, not at 4. First we'll check their continuity. So we'll check the continuity only at 4. Okay. So the first function will give 4 and the second function will give 2. Now because these two values are not same, so it means this function is discontinuous at x equal to 4. Okay. But the question is asking, find the interval where it is continuous. So yes, because it is discontinuous at 4, so it must be continuous at all other values except 4. So we'll just say continuous at x not equal to 4. Right? I hope it makes sense. Because the function is discontinuous at 4, so it must be continuous at all other values. Great. Let's come to next question, 14th. Fx is minus 2. This is also a linear function. This is also a linear function. So they must be continuous before 3 and after 3. So our only point is to check at 3 what happens. So at 3, this function is minus 2. And this function will check now, second function, it's minus 2 times 3 plus 6, we get 0. So, because these values are not equal, So for sure, this function is discontinuous at 3. So let me write discontinuous at x equal to 3. If it is discontinuous at x equal to 3, so where is it continuous? So continuous at all the values before 3 and all the values after 3. You can say x not equal to 3. Great. Let's try number 15. It's a rational function. We'll try to simplify numerator and denominator. X minus 1 over, you know how to factorize quadratic. So we get x minus 3, x minus 1. Now numerator and denominator we can cancel because they are the common factors. So we get 1 over x minus 3. So yes, there are two kinds of discontinuities, we know that. One is removable discontinuity at x equal to 1, because the common factor will give 1. And there is an infinite discontinuity at 3, because the denominator will make 0 at 3. X minus 3 equal to 0 will give x equal to 3. So there are two discontinuities at 1 and 3. I will just write discontinuous here. Discontinuous. Okay. But they have asked where is it continuous. So we'll just say continuous at all other values except 1 and 3. At all other values, they are continuous. Right? Let's try number 16. This is not a rational function at all. X square over 2 is throughout continuous for all values. So this function is a quadratic function basically, and it is continuous function. You know how does quadratic look like? It looks like this way or this way. So anyway, it is continuous throughout. So continuous at x belongs to R. So for all real values of x, the function is continuous. Come to 17. Again, 17 is also a quadratic function. So this is again continuous at all values of all real values of x. Continuous at x belongs to R. Let's try number 18. This function is a rational function. So first we'll try to simplify the numerator and denominator. So negative of x minus 2 over denominator, when do we factorize, we get x minus 2, x minus 1. Common factor is x minus 2, x minus 2. So for sure it is discontinuous at that value. So let me write discontinuous at x equal to 2. And when do we solve it? When do we cancel it? We will get 1 over x minus 1, minus 1 over x minus 1. So it is discontinuous at x minus 1 also. It means x equal to 1. So it is discontinuous at two values, where x is 2 and where x is 1. So where is it continuous? So we'll just say at all values except 2 and 1. Very quick, number 19, negative x minus 1, x factor common x minus 1. So it is discontinuous at x equal to 0 and at x equal to 1. So it is continuous at x and not equal to 1. Okay. Come to number 20. X over x minus 3, x minus 3. there is no removable discontinuity because there is no common factor. Yes, there is an infinite discontinuity when the denominator becomes zero, right? So we'll just say discontinuity at x equal to 3. So yes, where is it continuous? We'll just say continuous at not 3, means all other values except 3, the function is continuous. Okay, let's come to number 21. They have asked us, write a function that has an infinite discontinuity at x equal to 100. So guys, please understand, when do we get as an infinite discontinuity? When the denominator is 0, right? So you just need to write a function. Let me write down the function where your factors would be x minus 100. So whatever you write up or down doesn't matter. But you have an infinite discontinuity at the denominator also, x minus 100. Whether you write x minus 100 or x minus 100 whole square or whole cube, it is all infinite discontinuity. Okay. You can have different answers, not an issue. The only point is that denominator should be x minus 100. Okay. And you should not have a common factor with numerator denominator as x minus 100. Okay. Like you should not write like this x minus 100 over x minus 100. Okay. That you should not write. Numerator can be anything, but denominator has to be a factor of x minus 100. Let's do number 22. Write a function that is continuous over this. So you can see that the function has to be continuous all the way from minus infinity to 0 open, and from 0 open interval to 1 open interval, and 1 open interval to infinite. So it has to be discontinuous at 0 and at 1, because at 0 there is no x value at 0. That is an open interval, means x value does not attain 0, and x value does not attain 1, because at 1 also it is an open interval. I hope you understand the meaning of open interval. When I write 0 to 1 like this, here 1 is called an open interval, means all the values from 0 onwards up to before 1. Okay, that is called an open interval. If I write like this, 0 comma 1, so it is open at 0 but closed at 1. It means all the value after 0 and up to 1 means it will touch 1. So that is a closed interval, open closed interval at 1. But in this case, at 1 they are open interval, so it means the x value should not attain either 0 or 1. It means it has to be discontinuous at these points. So fine, we can have anything with that discontinuity. Again, you can have multiple answers. One of the easiest answer could be, because they did not mention what kind of discontinuity they want, so one of your answer could be just x minus 0 for your better x minus 1, which is basically 1 over x minus 1. So there could be multiple answers. This can be one of your answers. So thank you for the session today. See you soon.